שלום, בוקר טוב.
Hello, good morning. Thank you, Minister of Defense. We heard a very extensive review about the development and the concerns, and also the opportunities and mutual interests. All these are subjects we're going to deal with throughout these 2 days. We'll elaborate in a very fascinating way, I hope. I'd like to extend our wishes for success to the new chief of staff. He's entering office today. And to continue what the minister said, I think that this year, which just passed, is a year which focused on the fact that we cannot manage the conflict, truly, the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, the status quo dragging our feet. It's not good for Israel. They're damaging and they decline us to places we do not want to be in. And therefore, we have to advance towards a political agreement with responsibility cautiously. But to do it with wisdom, courage, and ways that we're going to discuss in this session, and according to a perception that the two states for the two peoples is a solution which is good for Israel as far as its national security, it's desired for the benefit of Israel for long term, and that's why we have to try and to advance with an Israeli initiative when we're holding all the time the reins of the process and we're not getting dragged towards it and we're not pushed aside to places we don't want to be in, neither in the international arena or the internal one in Israel. It's true, in fact, that this year also showed us that borders of 100 years in the Middle East are deleted, are erased as if they were never there. But the Jewish people needs a state which is its national home with clear and recognized and safe borders. And therefore, advancement towards a reality of two states for two peoples, even when still there's no arrangement, that is what we desire. The Israeli-Palestinian conflict, which is not advancing towards a solution, has a bad impact on our political and our security possibilities. It also impacts us as a Jewish and democratic state, a safe state. And we have to separate from the Palestinians. How to do it, we'll talk about it in a minute. The probability we're going to have a permanent agreement that will put an end to the conflict and an end to all the claims, probability for that at the moment is very, very low. Some people will say it doesn't exist, some people will say it doesn't, will not happen, but we see also the reasons for it, and we can analyze them. The Palestinians decided to go against the negotiations, to have nothing to do with us, and today they're acting in through diplomacy, through the courts, in the international arena, in a way that will probably put the political and the legal struggle in this arena at the head of the priorities of the State of Israel in the next couple of years. Of course, there's a mutual lack of trust between us and the Palestinians, which is deepening as the years go by. There's a gap which is unbridgeable to some of the core issues, and we'll hear about that maybe from Ambassador Indyk, who was the special envoy of the United States to the talks. And obviously, we are in conflicts, violent all the time between us and the Palestinians. Some people say once in 2 years, some people say even less than that. And therefore, we have to take the initiative. We must lead towards a reality of two states and two peoples in a few channels. So if one gets stuck, then the other can advance, and when one advances, then the others are can benefit from it in order to get to the target, to the objective we want. We're going to hear today almost from all angles, the Israeli angle, the American one, and unfortunately, because of a problem, one can say even an expected problem that happened this morning, the Palestinian representative, the spokesman, will not participate in this session. We, from the Institute, from INSS, we are going to present a perception which is complex, but responsible as far as we see it, both politically and security-wise. Today we begin, as we heard in the beginning of this day, we are also beginning to hold a short survey of every session. Maybe you can show us the slide of the questions for this session. Can you? Yes. You see the questions. Actually, it's one question with four answers, and you have to SMS to text a different answer. I'll give you a minute to organize yourself, and we'll see after the session what has changed. So take a minute now. Everybody has a cellular phone, hopefully on mute, and please reply. The question is there a chance to advance towards a solution of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict? The answers are a high probability, medium probability, small probability, no probability. Is there a chance to advance towards the solution of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict?
Okay.
It doesn't work, so it's okay. We'll continue. Okay, that will be improved later on. I just want to see together with you. Okay, forget the cell phones. There's something else. We're going to, in the next sessions, we can amend the problem. And now we go on to see together a very short movie, less than 5 minutes, which reviews everything that happens to us in the context that we're talking about in the last year.
It's not our intention to argue about the past.
Peace is possible.
Deal being kept of the release of prisoners and not going to the UN. 700 settlement units were announced in Jerusalem, and poof, that was sort of the moment.
هذه بشرى نزفها لشعبنا الفلسطيني في الوطن والشتات انتهاء مرحلة وسنوات الانقسام.
We intend to work with this government, but we'll be watching closely.
وأن أحافظ على استقلال الوطن ووحدة وسلامة أرضي.
عبادة كشر עם שלושה נערים באזור גוש עציון.
הערב נמצאו גופותיהם של שלושת הנערים.
תהום מוסרית רחבה ועמוקה מפרידה בינינו לבין אויבינו.
אין אנשים בממשלה רוצים שלום, אני רואה.
We believe that settlements are illegitimate and counterproductive to achieving two-state outcome.
אנחנו יודעים שהוא נצחק כאן, קיבלת?
הוא יצא מהציע, טיפול בדיוק, 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 טיפול
حدود فلسطين هي حدود هذه الصفقة غزة الضفة القدس و48
השגת אופק מדיני חדש למדינת ישראל
נזוף الى الأمة الإسلامية خبر تحرير معبر القنيطرة
وجيش الاحتلال في أبشع تطبيق ممكن من أنظمة الأبارتايد
ISIS and Hamas are branches of the same poisonous tree
El Parlamento español considera que el reconocimiento
la Asamblea Nacional ha adopté
ילדה תאורה, נשמה קדושה, שלא עשתה לאף אחד שום דבר רע בחיים.
פלאפון דלוק תמיד, כי אם יודיעו לי שיש אישור לבנות בית מקדש, אז אני עוזב באמצע.
המחבל שפוגע באזרחים, מקומו שיערב.
מאומות קשות בכפר קנה אחרי ששוטרים הרגו צעיר שהסתער עליהם בסכין.
צעיר נדקר ופונה במצב קשה לבית החולים תל השומר.
שני המחבלים מגיעים חמושים בגרזנים ובאקדח, גם יורים, גם תוקפים באמצעות הסכינים והגרזנים, ארבעה הרוגים בבית הכנסת.
אני נחוש להעביר את חוק הלאום.
ישראל קובעת אזרחים סוג ב'.
זה אותו משבר על אותו נושא כל הזמן.
אנחנו עוברים בינתיים להצבעה על הצעת חוק להתפזרות הכנסת ה-19.
Les otages peuvent enfin sortir de l'enfer.
Alors dans cette épreuve, je vous l'assure, nous sortirons encore plus fort.
Peace will come from hard choices and compromises that must be made at the negotiating table.
מי שצריך לתת את הדין אלה ראשי הרשות הפלסטינית שכרתו ברית עם פושע מלחמה של החמאס.
The first speaker in this session will be Moshe Chico Tamir, a Brigadier General in Reserves. He served 28 years in the IDF. He was a commander of a division. Today he's in a business company. He's going to talk about the security arrangements, if there's an initiative by Israel or in general, when we're still quite far from a permanent agreement. Good morning. I was asked to be part of a team, and I'll start with a personal note. I usually do not participate in such events, and I try to keep away from interviews in issues of security. The idea of unilateral separation from the Palestinian is a choice that we usually try to avoid. And the reason I did join this team, in order to give a professional opinion from a security point of view, if that's possible, without taking too many risks, it's because it's so important. The members of the team, if you can show the names. These are the members of the team. Gilad was the head. Avner from the INSS was also a coordinator. And we had Baruch Spiegel, Brigadier General Reserves, Ilan Shapira from the Shabak, and myself. Udi Dekel, the now CEO of INSS, joined us. And when the way we worked was from a professional point of view only, we didn't have any political planning or any personal opinions. We try to look at this process in the most professional way possible. This is the question of the study that we related to. Is it possible to do any unilateral process in Judea and Samaria that will maintain the security interests of Israel on the one hand, and on the other hand will bring about benefits in the way Israel controls Judea and Samaria, and a political benefit long term? As I said, we focused only on security, but in Judea and Samaria, like in any other issue, obviously there are many other aspects as well, like the civil aspects, the political aspect. We also spoke about it. We didn't elaborate, we didn't analyze, except for how is it going to impact security in if there is a unilateral process. I want to share with you the main insights that we reached. We met quite a few times. And the first thing is, what is the scope of a unilateral actions that we can do without jeopardizing security? We came to an agreement that the scope of unilateral disengagement from Judea and Samaria, it cannot be full. It can only be in the back settlements like Hebron. This is going to be our recommendation, and it's part of our report. The Jordan Valley has to remain, from a security point of view, definitely in a unilateral disengagement, in Israeli full control. The same goes for the settlements along the fence. The second insight was that it's obvious that such a process will not be taken favorably, so we will not have any cooperation or international support. It has to be a directing line in the activity or planning such an activity. Jordan can be a key, especially in the border crossings, but also in other places, and that's why it is also part of this triangle. Apart from the United States international community, Jordan is also a key country, as opposed to what we did not do with Egypt when we disengaged from Gaza. The collaboration with the Palestinian Authority is not a condition for unilateral activity on the one hand, but it can alleviate in a very significant way. That's why civil and especially security collaboration can make things easier for all of us and for the IDF. The two last points are, first of all, we did not deal at all with the evacuation. That's a civil issue, but it's going to have an impact on security as well. And that's why the preparation is a wide one. The opposition that will be to such evacuation is going to be real. It's going to be very serious. And the body that will have to prepare for that will have to do it very thoroughly. And the last thing is, that the outline that we looked at did not take into account the political situation of Judea and Samaria the way it is today, but if there's a more serious development that the Hamas will take over, that's probability, if there's a unilateral process of Israel. Therefore, the assumption that anybody who's going to plan anything has to be that, first of all, the regime is not the Palestinian Authority as we know it today, but from the security point of view, you have to take into account deterioration, like happened in Gaza. And the other thing is, you have to look at the scope and what's happening, because it's going to have an impact as well. The principles of the outline. The first thing is an isolation of Judea and Samaria from the possibility of empowering and arming terror organizations. If you look at Gaza, you understand that the main mistake we made is that we left the Egyptian border open, and we enabled armament continuous and very significant of Hamas. Hamas within a decade managed to arm itself, to enforce itself in all the military echelons, and if it happens in Judea and Samaria, it's going to be a disaster. That's why the Jordan Valley and the crossings and the scope of the fence around Judea and Samaria, it's a key in instilling security. The second thing is the freedom of movement for the IDF within Judea and Samaria. In any outline, the freedom of movement for the IDF has to be maintained. Even if the PA is not going to do its role and will not collaborate, the IDF and the Shabak must have freedom of movement throughout the area, including the cities, if they have to. Therefore, that gradual flexibility of the IDF will only be through collaboration. If there's collaboration, gradually you can reduce the pressure of the IDF on Judea and Samaria. But if there's no such collaboration, the IDF will actually have to remain in the same mode of action as it is today, apart from the burden of defending some of the settlements that exist. The next steps, the three main points I spoke about are the main ones, are the central ones, the isolation of the area, freedom of movement for the IDF, and the collaboration with the Palestinians. Other points are additionals, which may alleviate. One is a political effort that for security it has to give legitimacy to the activity. We need a possibility that the IDF will continue to thwart and to stop terror within Judea and Samaria, and if it's not done by the Palestinians. And out of that, maybe we can understand that the strategy of the IDF in Gaza is one of deterrence. Namely, we left the area. Any activity that the Hamas does, IDF is going to give them 10 times more. We see in Judea and Samaria a completely different way. It has to be of a complete capability and not to enable in any way any armament, any force. They cannot have military force or terror that can act against the State of Israel. That's why the IDF activity has to be consistent and to prevent anything that is done in Gaza. This is if we leave this freedom of movement, what can happen in the Judea and Samaria can actually endanger the home front of the State of Israel in a very significant way. Additional two recommendations. One is the evacuation. For security reasons, we looked at possibilities of evacuation. We analyzed them, and our recommendation is that if they want to go to a unilateral process gradually, as was done in the north of Samaria, to do it gradually and not in one go, so that we will be able to look at the impact on security and also to maintain security during the process and after it. And the last point is the preparation to cope with the evacuation. We didn't actually go into the details, so I don't want to elaborate, but this is actually what we dealt with, and the main conclusion, the most important one of the team, is that a unilateral process limited in Judea and Samaria is possible from a security point of view. You still maintain the interests of the State of Israel, and you can keep the security within Judea and Samaria and towards the State of Israel on condition that this process is limited in the conditions that I explained.